Today I'm going to talk about a water system to deliver water down on a steep property, like properties like that. There's a big drop there, but I have some water coming in. Yeah. So my point is, my idea is to collect this water and divert it through the system of barrels and hoses like this down to the bottom of the property. So I'll show you how I've done it, how I have done it. So basically it's just a little collector of the water, and I use this to protect from elements. And here I have the hose and some mesh to protect from debris coming down from trees. So the water is kind of getting in clean and then goes through this hose, which is just a regular water hose for the garden. Goes down. I have two hoses coming in because I have two water collection points up there. So one hose goes on top like that, on top of the barrel, like that, and you see this water from top is going through this mesh that came with the barrel into the barrel. See? Okay. Now the second one is connected right here. It's this kind of connector. So both of hoses feed in into the barrel. Now this water barrel has a hose connected to the bottom, and I have a connector here that goes down to one section of my property where I use the water most. So I can use the water from this point, but now when it overflows from this barrel, I have a couple of things going on here. One is overflow water going out of here and also through this place, through this hose, bigger hose, into this big hose down there. So this is pretty much it. So the thing is that I have several barrels on the different levels of the property. The first one is right here, and then I have three more at different levels, and eventually they go all the way down to the very bottom. So it works pretty well. So I have water on each level, which I can use. So very affordable solution. The barrels came from Home Depot, I think. It's just a plastic barrel with things like that. This mesh is pretty useful. I see these things, the birds, they're trying to, you know, get in to drink it. So big ravens I have here, they're trying to destroy it, but they hold pretty much good so far. So it also protects you from the elements coming down, but from trees. Okay, so this works pretty well. Now here's another barrel on another level, but it's upside down. It's actually in the winter situation, winter conditions. So for the winter, this one was emptied and put upside down so that the frost doesn't damage your thing. So for now, at this level, I don't use any water. So my water goes all the way from top level through this hose, actually through this couple of hoses, big one and small one, to the bottom down there. So yeah, for the winter, I mean, people recommend turn this thing upside down if you don't use it. Okay, so. But when you need to use the water on this level, they just connect them all together. The system is the same. Like you see those connectors there. Okay, this is the bottom. And here's the overflow connector that I put in. Actually, I didn't put in. This is just like that. Yeah. Here's yet another barrel on the third level. Also in the winter position, so. My water just goes down there, just like that, in this. This hole, so, but if I need to water here or accumulate a bit more water just in case for a large use, so I will put it on. And this is my last barrel on the very bottom level. Basically the same system. So water coming from top goes into here. In case I have overflow, it goes from here and just flows over. But in case I need some water on the bottom of this barrel, I use this hose that provides me access to water at this level. Very simple, but very efficient system. So. Here's the illustration of the water availability on one of the levels here. The pressure is pretty big because it comes down from maybe 80, 90 feet, maybe 100 feet. Above from the barrel, which is about 100 feet above or something like that. So the pressure is pretty good. Yeah, I use it for all kinds of things. Thanks.